CNN, as the coldest air of the season spreads across the eastern U.S., even some southern states are feeling the chill.
From Louisiana to the Carolinas, even down through Florida, temperatures are averaging 10 to 15 degrees below normal.
Freeze warnings and hard freeze warnings are in effect across Florida and Georgia through Wednesday morning.
Tuesday afternoon, the National Weather Service in Miami issued a rare forecast regarding cold temperatures, but it was for iguanas. Yes, you read that correctly.
Iguanas.
Read more.
Don't be surprised if you see iguanas falling from the trees tonight, tweeted the Miami National Weather Service office. The concern for people in South Florida is that these iguanas often sleep in trees, so when their bodies go dormant, they appear to fall from the sky onto streets, cars, pools, or even people walking around. And since iguanas are large, adult males can reach 5 feet in length, and weigh up to 20 pounds, this can be dangerous if one lands on top of you.
The invasive species can't handle cold temperatures very well because they are cold-blooded. In general, iguanas begin to get sluggish or lethargic once the temperature drops below 50 degrees Fahrenheit.
Once the temperature drops below 45 degrees Fahrenheit, the iguanas go into a dormant or cold stunned state. They appear to be dead, but they are not. They remain breathing with critical body functions still operating.
It is their body's way of protecting them until the temperature warms up back up above 50 degrees.
If those temperatures remain in the 40s for periods over 8 hours, a significant number of those iguanas will die, especially the smaller ones.
Just watched frozen iguanas fall out of trees in Florida. Replay more videos. Must watch playing on play video play play mute mute current time 0:00 duration time 0:00 loaded 0% 0:00 progress 0% 0:00 progress 0% live remaining time 0:00 descriptions off selected descriptions subtitles language full screen HD options start casting watch in VR subtitles language settings quality automatic automatic HD speed normal subtitle options quality automatic speed 0.25 0.5 normal 1.25 1.52 subtitle options font family default font color default font opacity default font size default background color default background opacity default window opacity default character edge style default font family default monospaced serif proportional serif monospaced sans serif proportional sans serif font color default white yellow green cyan blue magenta red black font opacity default 25% 50% 75% 100% font size default 50% 75% 100% 150% 200% background color default white yellow green cyan blue magenta red black background opacity default 0% 25% 50% 75% 100% window color default white yellow green cyan blue magenta red black window opacity default 0% 25% 50% 75% 100% character edge style default none drop shadow raised depressed uniform this is a modal window. Caption settings dialogue beginning of dialogue window. Escape will cancel and close the window. Text color white black red green blue yellow magenta cyan transparency opaque semi-transparent background color black white red green blue yellow magenta cyan transparency opaque semi-transparent transparent window color black white red green blue yellow magenta cyan transparency transparent semi-transparent opaque font size 50% 75% 100% 125% 150% 175% 200% 300% 400% 100% text edge style none raised depressed uniform drop shadow font family proportional sans serif proportional serif monospace serif casual script small caps defaults done frozen iguanas fall out of trees in Florida 132.
The temperature threshold for when iguanas begin to go into a dormant state depends greatly on the size of the iguana, explains Ron Magill, communications director for Zoo Miami. Generally speaking, the larger the iguana, the more cold it can tolerate for longer periods.
He also demonstrates how even though extended periods of air temperatures in the 40s could lead to the demise of some iguanas. Many iguanas in South Florida have adapted to going deep into burrows where they stay insulated from the cold. They tend to also live close to large bodies of water, which tend to be warmer than the air temperatures, which help them survive short cold snaps.
Get more weather news from around the world.
Not everyone is concerned about the well-being of these iguanas, though. They are considered an invasive species, so some people are looking forward to an opportunity to rid their yards of these reptiles.
I do know that there are several iguana hunters that are looking forward to this upcoming cold front, as it will certainly facilitate them removing these invasive reptiles from the South Florida environment, as they will not be able to run away, Majel told CNN.